Lopatinib, Wikipedia audio. Lopatinib, used in the form of lopatinib detoxylate, is an orally active drug for breast cancer and other solid tumors. It is a dual tyrosine kinase inhibitor which interrupts the HER2/Nu and epidermal growth factor receptor pathways. It is used in combination therapy for HER2-positive breast cancer. It is used for the treatment of patients with advanced or metastatic breast cancer whose tumors overexpress HER2. On March 13, 2007, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved lopatinib in combination therapy for breast cancer patients already using capecitabine. In January 2010, Tykerb received accelerated approval for the treatment of postmenopausal women with hormone receptor-positive metastatic breast cancer that overexpresses the HER2 receptor and for whom hormonal therapy is indicated. Pharmaceutical company GlaxoSmithKline markets the drug under the proprietary names Tykerb and T-Verb. The drug currently has approval for sale and clinical use in the U.S., Australia, Bahrain, Kuwait, Venezuela, Brazil, New Zealand, South Korea, Switzerland, Japan, Jordan, the European Union, Lebanon, India, and Pakistan. Status. On the August 2, 2013, India's Intellectual Property Appellate Board revoked the patent for Glaxo's Tykerb, citing its derivative status, while upholding at the same time the original patent granted for lopatinib. The drug lopatinib detoxylate is classified as S/NM, that is, naturally derived or inspired substrate. Lopatinib inhibits the tyrosine kinase activity associated with two oncogenes, EGFR and HER2/Nu. Overexpression of HER2/Nu can be responsible for certain types of high-risk breast cancers in women. Like sorafenib, lopatinib is a protein kinase inhibitor shown to decrease tumor-causing breast cancer stem cells. Lopatinib inhibits receptor signal processes by binding to the ADP binding pocket of the EGFR/HER2 protein kinase domain, preventing self-phosphorylation and subsequent activation of the signal mechanism. Lopatinib is used as a treatment for women's breast cancer in treatment-naive, ER+/EGFR+/HER2+ breast cancer patients and in patients who have HER2-positive advanced breast cancer that has progressed after previous treatment with other chemotherapeutic agents, such as anthracycline, taxane-derived drugs, or trastuzumab. A 2006 GSK-supported randomized clinical trial on female breast cancer previously being treated with those agents demonstrated that administrating lopatinib in combination with capecitabine delayed the time of further cancer growth compared to regimens that use capecitabine alone. The study also reported that risk of disease progression was reduced by 51%. And that the combination therapy was not associated with increases in toxic side effects. The outcome of this study resulted in a somewhat complex and rather specific initial indication for lopatinib use only in combination with capecitabine for HER2-positive breast cancer in women whose cancer have progressed following previous chemotherapy with anthracycline, taxanes, and trastuzumab. Like many small molecule tyrosine kinase inhibitors, lopatinib is regarded as well tolerated. The most common side effects reported are diarrhea, fatigue, nausea, and rashes. Of note, lopatinib-related rash is associated with improved outcome. In clinical studies, elevated liver enzymes have been reported. QT prolongation has been observed with the use of lopatinib detoxylate, but there are no reports of torsades de pointes. Caution is advised in patients with hypokalemia, hypomagnesemia, congenital long QT syndrome, or with co-administration of medicines known to cause QT prolongation. In combination with capecitabine, reversible decreased left ventricular function are common. Phase 3 study designed to assess lopotinib in combination with chemotherapy for advanced HER2-positive gastric cancer in 2013 failed to meet the primary endpoint of improved overall survival against chemotherapy alone. The trial did not discover new safety signals, while the median OS for patients in the lopotinib and chemotherapy group was 12.2 months against 10.5 months for patients in the placebo plus chemotherapy. Secondary endpoints of the randomized, double-blinded study were progression-free survival, response rate, and duration of response. Median PFS was 6 months. Response rate was 53% and the duration of response was 7.3 months in the investigational combination chemotherapy group compared to median PFS of 5.4 months, response rate of 39% and duration of response of 5.6 months for patients in chemotherapy alone group. Diarrhea, vomiting, anemia, dehydration and nausea were serious adverse events reported in over 2% of patients in the investigational combination chemotherapy group, while vomiting was the most common SAE noted in the chemotherapy group. Mode of action. RET inhibitors, vanditanib, entrectinib. C-MET inhibitor, cabozantinib. Biochemistry. Clinical application. Breast cancer. Adverse effects. Ongoing trials in gastric cancer.